is Camp Hannon, who is a Republican, and the only reason the Republican is chairing that committee is because of the IDC. But the question I want to ask you is because Alcantara is an example. She was supported by the New York State Nurses Association and other unions. There's not a single Democrat in New York State that gets elected without union support. And she, you know, they supported her because they support, they fund the campaign for New York Health. And they supported her because she was going to be a vote in the Senate for New York Health. And yet, you know, now I'm finding out this really interesting history about who's really funding her. So I'm wondering if you have any insight about how we can engage with the labor movement, because the labor movement is a real key player in Democratic politics in New York State. Woo! So, a great example, the New York Health Act is a great example, and Alcantara is a great example. And I actually think one of the reasons it's so important for Robert Jackson to win is because Robert Jackson will be a sign. First of all, he's a great progressive. He will represent his district. But second, he'll be a sign that you don't get to say something, and then there's an immediate public response. An immediate, you know, you get elected, you switch over to the IDC, you do not represent people in this district anymore. So I actually think Jackson's race is incredibly important. On labor, there's a lot of different players. And my own view is I can really disagree with some of the choices made by labor leaders. Look, I disagree with all of the last governor's race. and I will be open about that disagreement. And at the same time, I'm going to be out there on the strike line. So I think it's important to be supporting the IBEW strike right now against Spectrum in New York City. You know, that it's bold saying, I'm going to be there for you, and I'm going to be unafraid about disagreeing with you, because New York, the woman who asked the last question, I think it was John Oliver said, if you want to do something really evil, make it really complicated. maybe it was Colbert, I forget which one. It is so, or they said boring, but this is complicated. It's, New York politics is like, our people are so much better than our politics.
Question?
Will you please primary out that corporate work?
No response. I'm going to give the last question to Jay, who is super involved with Progressive Resist. If I didn't call you, I'm so sorry. This is a popular section, but we're going to go here and then we're going to wrap it up. Again, thank you so much for coming and joining us today. We talked a lot about the hedge funders, the revenue, the real estate interests that are funding the IDC, that are really trying to, you know, and we know how much the real estate industry is destroying New York City, both for people's housing and for people, for shops and for retail, et cetera. How much money is Cuomo getting from these industries? How much money are those county chairs
getting from this industry. Because when we keep coming against these people that are supposed to be solid Democrats, doing the work that we need them to do, and somehow they just can't seem to overcome this IDC thing. You know, follow the money usually leads you to the right place. So I'm just wondering if that information is out there.
Yeah, it's out there, and the you asked about two different characters, but it really is mostly to Andrew Cuomo himself. You know, the county chairs are not these, like, with exceptions. That's not where the and interesting exceptions. But really, it's about Cuomo himself. I mean, when I ran against him last time, we were after 6 weeks. I think we had more donors than he did. Now, granted, our donors gave like $10, but he really relies on. There was a Shane Goldwalker New York Times story on this a few months ago about his website. He has sort of zero low dollar. So it's not just that he's making a little money off of high dollar. He's like all high dollar. And when you have that kind of dependency, there's a huge problem there. So I think what you're doing, calling out that connection, and this real estate connection is like, I mean, it's a tragedy. It is a daily tragedy for people's lives, and it's a tragedy for the city, it's a tragedy for the state. And it's talking a handful of people who are just holding on to power for their own profit. And we can do so much better than that. And real estate, I mean, that's Trump world.
Yeah.
You know, like, we're just